Greetings, Guardians. My name is Byfe here. So today I wanted to answer some questions that a lot of you have been asking me since the release of the Destiny 2 Rally the Troops trailer. Namely, where are all our ghosts? Why don't we have our powers anymore? And why does the Traveler look so different in that first shot of the trailer? Before we go any further, we should definitely clarify a few things. First of all, Nolan North did confirm that he was reprising his role as the Ghost in Destiny 2. It's also worth noting that not all the trailers in Destiny feature both the Guardians and their ghosts. Take, for example, the Law of the Jungle trailer from Destiny 1. We also can't be 100% certain of why we're going to need to regain our powers in Destiny 2. However, there's some pretty interesting stuff that has to be taken into account when it comes to the invasion of the Red Legion, the messages sent back from the Skyburners, and why this forced that motion by the Emperor. So with all that information in hand, we're going to try and use it to fit together a couple of theories, and then we're going to use those to potentially explain the answers to some of the questions you have. First of all, I want to draw your attention to a piece of grimoire that pertains to the Cabal and what they know about ghosts, guardians, and our ability to be resurrected by the ghosts. The card details a series of Cabal attacks made against guardians, with the results almost always being the same. Cabal numbers being decimated, their positions being overrun, and guardians, even when killed, being revived by their ghosts. Due to the failure of translation, the grimoire card here refers to ghosts as, quote, dead people. The most important part of this, however, is the analysis at the end of the card, which is undoubtedly vital because it provides some important context in this hour of confusion and uncertainty. It provides the secondary context required to understand why the Cabal attack the Dreadnought in the first place. The card reads as follows. The primary threat is the Guardian's individual counter-attrition capability. Guardians can be rebuilt after even total disintegrative trauma. This capability is provided by a small autonomous drone unit called a dead person, translation unclear. The dead person conceals itself during combat. It is not a viable target for direct fire. Saturation attack by artillery, heavy air, or orbital fire may have good effects, although guardians transmat frequently and refuse to assemble in large formations. Flare analysis suggests that the Hive have developed unconventional counter-dead person capabilities. The capture of Hive leadership might yield vital strategic intelligence, including weapons or tactics capable of defeating Guardians permanently. We advance that the Hive fleet group near Saturn presents a strong target. For the Primus, our highest duty done, unflinchingly loyal, Skyburner's 5th cohort, Auxiliaries, Strategic Intelligence Maniple. It appears that we have become enough of a thorn in their side that they would seek to blight our immortality by any means necessary. We decimated their legions and brought chaos to the Cabal's Martian campaign. It's clear now that whilst the Vex were a point of concern to the Cabal, they were not the greatest adversary in this situation, and nor were the Hive. We were always the highest priority targets on the battlefield and in intelligence briefings. To contain us, it would appear that the Cabal are willing to go to any length, no matter how desperate it might seem. To attempt to capture the Ascendant Hive is a fool's gambit, as the Primus of the Skyburners would discover personally. However, their mere presence on the Dreadnought means that they may have unearthed vital secrets about the very nature of the Light, Guardians, and the Traveler. After all, the Hive have hunted the Traveler since their species ascended from the murky depths of Fundament. Even a piece of information as small as the fact that our Light comes from the Traveler itself might have given the Cabal enough of an idea of what they needed to do. My real question is then this. What if the Cabal discovered what the Hive's plans were when it came to the invasion of Sol? More specifically, what if they discovered how the Hive drained the Traveler of its light in the Chamber of Night mission? Now, amazingly enough, that transmission from earlier was sent up the Cabal chain of command, and the message was sent all the way back, and it came from the top of the Cabal Empire. The invasion of the Dreadnought was a very deliberate response to the transmission which contained information about the power of Guardians. It wasn't a response to the fact that Cabal numbers were being decimated on Mars and Phobos. It wasn't even a response necessarily to the appearance of the Taken. This was our doing. We were the cause of this reaction. The fact that this information came back and the fact that they had been ordered to attack the Dreadnought was actually a point of conversation between Valis T'Lern and Primus Taun during a battle that the Skyburners were having with the Vex, which proceeded as follows. Particle beams scream and spark off his enormous bulk. Taun yanks him back to cover. A maniple of Phalanx troops rush forward to plug the gap. I have my orders. Our report went all the way up, and the decision came all the way back down. Valis T'Lern's blank helmet swivels to stare. You mean... It came from the Emperor himself. Taun can feel the pressure gel pumping against his skin, keeping him insulated from this deadly world, keeping him alive. I'm ordered to board and capture the Hive flagship, at any cost. The Vex Minotaur blinks up behind the Phalanx line. Primus Taun's armor paints the target, and he absolutely unloads, putting all his fear and anger and sorrow into the wretched machine. He roars and roars, the Minotaur burns, his soldiers cheer. That's a job for an elite unit, not a few scout legions bogged down in attrition war. We should wait until it's the mission I've been given. I will use what I have. The Traveler is the source of a great deal of our light, and our ghosts were created in defense of that light. They give rebirth to those capable of wielding the Traveler's light as a weapon. Ever jumped off the tower and thought, that's okay, I'll just respawn. Not without your ghost, you won't. So in order to stop us from continuously regenerating, the Cabal would need to take out our ghosts, and in order to strip us of our other powers like the ability to wield the light, for the most part, they'd need to stop the Traveler from emitting the light that we wield, be that the light of a gunslinger, a Nova Bomb from a Voidwalker, or even something as simple as a Fist of Havoc from a Titan. The Hive's method was to drain the Traveler of its light, and probably consume it. But if light flows, and can be channeled, there's no reason why the Cabal might not be able to contain it. In the first shot of the Rally the Troops trailer, we can see that the Traveler does indeed look different. It looks shielded if you look up close, and the shield has the same pigmentation and laser-like structure as that of the new Phalanx shields that we see in the exact same trailer. I believe that this is the work of the Cabal, who've been able to contain the Traveler's light. Now the next question is, what about our ghosts? Well, seeing as they're linked to the Traveler, it's entirely within the bounds of possibility that cutting us off from the Traveler might also have cut off our ghosts, potentially even deactivating them. Having said that, all of this is entirely theoretical. Something that's much more troubling is the idea that we could lose all our abilities that are born of the Traveler. There's actually a little evidence for this, as in the Rally the Troops trailer, there's only ever one use of what we might consider an ability, and that's where Ikora uses Arc Lightning to take out this Phalanx. This is actually pretty significant, because the light of Stormcallers, much like that of Nightstalkers and Sunbreakers, is not light that originates from the Traveler. These subclasses instead rely on light-wielding techniques that can be found and learned from out in the wild. Sunbreaker's hammers are, for example, quite literally called the Hammer of Sol, because the light they use to forge their hammers is drawn directly from the sun at the center of our solar system. Meanwhile, Nightstalkers harness their shadow shots by quite literally drawing it forth from the void and the light there. And the Stormcallers, in the Stormcaller subclass quest, actually gain their arc powers by literally becoming one with an arc storm. These powers, and many others, are probably what we need to learn in Destiny 2 as a result of our powers being cut off from the Traveler. However, in a story context, this gives us a very good reason why Gaul's tactics were so brilliant. These abilities to wield light that does not originate from the Traveler are exceptionally rare. Stormcallers are amongst the rarest of Guardians. Nightstalkers are so unheard of that when one is found, they are often a point of being taboo. And Sunbreakers are mercenary guardians who have no tie to the city and trust only in the light born of Sol itself and the fire there. So, with all of this information pieced together, there's two theories I want to present. One, either Gaul has attacked the Traveler and in the process contained its light, cutting a great number of guardians off from their abilities, which means that we have to search for new techniques to wield light. And secondly, the idea that Gaul has attacked the Traveler and in order to preserve its light, our ghosts have shielded the Traveler from the Cabal onslaught, thus meaning the diminishing of our own light and the requirement to find new sources of it out in the wild. But of course, all of this is just theory, and I want to know what you guys think of this. Do you have your own ideas as to why we're losing our powers in Destiny 2? If you do, tell me in the comments section down below. And if you enjoyed this video, please do leave a like, it really does help me out in the channel side of things. And if you want more Destiny and Destiny 2 content, then you can also subscribe to my channel, and if you never want to miss a video that I make, you can hit the bell next to subscribe to turn on email notifications, so that whenever I make a piece of content, you will be notified of it. But of course, your viewership is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name has been My Name Is Byfe. Prodacia ad astra. I'll see you, Starside.